Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and today we are going to start Activity 1.1 in Flight and Space. So let's get cracking. Alrighty, Flight and Space friends, when we hit Lesson 1 Flight, it starts by giving us the goals that we're going to have. Don't stress this. Just read them, and it's going to happen later. They also talk about materials. Read them. Don't sweat it. I will have them out when it's time. There is a design process reflection table. You will fill this out when you're working and when you're done. But right now we can just go back and move to the next tab. I need you to read this little flight section and I need you to read the design challenge. You will have a partner. I'll pick those when it's time to get to them. You are going to design, build, and test a prototype glider, and it will have to consistently land on a target. This is called the design brief. I want you to learn about your client, the consumer, and who you're aiming for. Read through the problem that you're going to have to solve, and then check out the design statement. You need to be able to restate this back to me so that I know that you're ready to move to the part where you actually start building. When it is time to build, notice I am highlighting, you will create a successful paper airplane glider prototype with your partner. I'm going to highlight that in mine so it stays noticeable. The requirements must be out of paper. You may use tape and paper clips. Glider must be built and tested in the time allowed. We're going to have 2 class days with the time that I give you to complete this project. It must launch from a horizontal position. You must be at a starting line. It must fly 1.5 meters successfully to land on the target. Once again, you can highlight these things. You can add notes. The toes of the person launching must be behind, and it must land with at least half its body inside the target circle to be counted good. And the recorder must record the results. We will get to the who picks. We will document progress as we go. If we go all the way back to this first page where it said design process reflection table, you should now know what the problem is, and this is what you fill out. Later, you'll write down how smart you could have been. You will generate concepts in a little bit. Remember to be creative and generate lots of ideas. Do not just use airplanes from the past. Make sure you follow the safety steps when you're flying, and then document and design all your work in your digital notebook we created. Make sure you have the names of your partners. Make sure you record ideas and concepts. Make sure you have diagrams of your airplane. You may be able to use screenshots depending on how you came up with yours. And then note any modifications you've made to your design. Remember, at the end, you must record the results. And your results need to be in a table like this. You need at least 3, but I'd love to have more. Note, when we are finished, you will informally present to class your findings. Friends, I hope you find this useful and it makes you more successful as you're doing the Instant Design Challenge. Friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. If you got a question, comment, or suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.